chlorophyll. There is a pigment called chlorophyll in the leaves. That is what it gives the exclusive green color to the leaf. Green color to the leaf, chlorophyll pigment. So chlorophyll is a green colored pigment which will be obtained in the presence of sunlight. So what are the parts of the leaf? The middle part of the leaf, the line this passes, no? This is known as the midrib. And these parallel things are known as the veins of the leaf. And then the outer covering of the leaf is known as the lamina. And they are small pores or holes all over the leaf, known as stomata. And then the part where from the leaf, the part where the leaf starts from the stem, the lower part of the leaf is known as petiole. So these are the different parts of the leaf: midrib, veins, lamina, stomata and petiole. So what are the main functions of the leaf? The main function of the leaf is photosynthetic activity. That means it prepares the food. So plants prepare food from carbon dioxide and water. Plants take in carbon dioxide during the daytime, right, in the presence of sunlight, for preparing food, and water also. So how we water the plants, right? So plants prepare the food from carbon dioxide and water in the presence of chlorophyll and sunlight. So in the presence of sunlight, plants prepare the food. That activity is known as photosynthesis. The main function of the leaf is preparation of food for the plant. That is photosynthesis. And one more function, major function of the leaf is breathing activity. So stomata, which are present like pores or small holes on the leaf, help in facilitating the breathing. So there are only two major functions of the leaf. That is photosynthesis, preparation of food, and breathing. Breathing through the small holes or pores like structures on the leaf called stomata. So these are the veins on the leaf. So this may be appear different. These appear as different veins for every different plant. So arrangement of veins is known as venation. So the arrangement of leaf on the arrangement of veins on the leaf is known as venation. These venation can be of two types: reticulate venation or parallel venation. Parallel means, you know, no? Side by side. So example, the grass which grows on the ground, we see, you know, grow in a V-shaped structure. So that is nothing but like a parallel venation. So in parallel venation is where veins are running parallel to each other. So grass plant, you see, right, they run parallel to each other like a V-shaped structure. And as well as wheat and rice plants also, the leaves have veins in a parallel venation direction. So what is reticulate venation? In reticulate venation, the veins on the leaves form a network-like or net-like structure. So net, you know, no, closely woven net. So reticulate venation, the veins form a network or net-like structure. This can be seen in banyan plant, mango plant, and as well as the jackfruit plant. So venation is nothing but the arrangement of veins on the leaves. Venation can be two types: reticulate, that is veins appear as a network or net-like structure, and parallel venation is the veins run parallel to each other. So that is about the veins of the leaf. Then transpiration. Transpiration is the main process one which plants do. So in the water cycle, which we have read earlier, so in the water cycle also, water vapor comes into the atmosphere through the transpiration process. So loss of water vapor from the plants through the stomata and lenticles is known as the transpiration. The transpiration is the process from which the plant loses its excess water and leaves it into the atmosphere. So transpiration is the process where the plant gives away its excess water to the atmosphere in the form of water vapor. So in the presence of sunlight, the excess water in the leaf evaporates and goes up into the sky in the form of water vapor. So this method of loss of water is known as transpiration. So the next part will be stomata. So stomata also play a main important role in the leaf. They appear as the small openings or holes all through the surface of the leaf, mostly on the lower side of the leaf. And then they allow the exchange of gases. So either entry of gas or exit of the gas, that is carbon dioxide and oxygen, also occurs through stomata. Water vapor loss occurs through stomata, and the breathing process also occurs through stomata. Unwanted water is removed from the leaf in the form of water vapor from the stomata. So water vapor is also gone into the atmosphere, that is excessive water present in the leaf is lost in the form of water vapor through the stomata only, and this process is called transpiration, right, the loss of water vapor. So this is about the leaf. Till now we have studied about leaf, right? Now we'll see some activities to prove the functions of the leaf. What are the functions of the leaf? Transpiration and photosynthesis, right? So suppose if you take a potted plant, take one stem of that potted plant and take two leaves of that one stem and tie a transparent polythene bag to it. Understood, right? Take a potted plant, select a stem from a plant. From that stem, take two leaves. Just imagine two leaves and tie a polythene bag, transparent polythene bag to that two leaves and tighten it with a string. Put it in the sunlight for few hours and observe after few hours. What do you observe? You observe droplets of water in that transparent polythene cover. So what does it prove? It proves that there was water loss in the form of water vapor by the process called transpiration. So the leaves were giving out excess water to the atmosphere in the form of water vapor by a process called transpiration. So the water droplets which were seen in that packet, transparent polythene packet, after few hours of putting it in the sunlight, those water drops indicated the presence of water vapor. How is water vapor lost into the atmosphere? By a process called transpiration. So here we could prove the transpiration function of the leaf. Then one more experiment is there to prove the presence of starch. Starch is nothing but the food of the plant. By the photosynthetic activity, plants prepare food, right? That food is stored in the form of starch or carbohydrates. So you have to take a burner and you have to take a strand and put a beaker. In this beaker, fill it with water. So on the stand, you have put a beaker with water and you have started heating the water in the burner. And in that beaker, you have to put a test tube. The test tube will be filled with spirit. And in that spirit, a green leaf will be kept. A stand, a candle burner, a beaker with water, in that beaker with water, a test tube filled with a leaf and spirit. And then you are heating it for some time. After heating it for some time, the water will boil and the spirit will take all the green color of the leaf. Understood? The water will boil after heating it for some time, right? And when the water boils, it will get heated. At that stage, what happens? The green color of the leaf will completely go into the spirit and the leaf will become colorless. When the leaf become colorless, take it out from the test tube and put it in a bowl. Add few drops of iodine to that bowl. Then what you observe, the leaf shows a blue or black color. It lost all the green color when boiled in spirit, right? Then you have taken it out from the test tube and put it in a bowl of iodine. What do you observe after putting it in a bowl of iodine? You observe that there is a black or blue color seen. So what does that indicate? It indicates that there was starch in the leaf. Understood? The presence of blue or black color indicates the presence of starch. Starch is nothing but the food of the leaf, food of the plant. So this experiment proved the presence of the starch. Then there is one more experiment, black paper experiment, to prove the photosynthetic activity. Take a potted plant, select one leaf. To a leaf, attach a thin strip of black colored polythene paper. So any black colored polythene cover you take and stick it to middle part of one leaf. Put it in the sunlight for some time. And after that, take it out from the sunlight and test for the presence of starch. So what do you observe? When this plant was kept in the sunlight, photosynthetic activity happened. That means plant prepared the food in the presence of sunlight. So the plant had, the leaf attained green color because of the presence of chlorophyll and photosynthetic activity. But that part of the leaf which was covered with black paper did not get the green color, did not prepare the food, so it didn't have starch in it. So when we remove this black paper, we see the difference in the color. So all this part of the leaf will be green, whereas the part which is covered with black paper will not be that much green. And we can test this leaf again with iodine. So whether it shows a blue-black solution or blue-black color or not, we can observe. So that is black paper experiment. To any potted plant, select a leaf, attach a black paper, polythene paper tightly to one part of the leaf, put it in the sun for some time. In the presence of the sun, photosynthetic activity happens, the plant prepares the food. Then take it out from the sunlight, cut this leaf, take out the black paper, test for the presence of starch with the help of iodine. this part of the plant will show the blue-black color because it prepared the food in the presence of sunlight. But this part which was covered with black paper will not show the presence of starch. So that is how the function of the leaf was scrolled. Moving on to the root. Root is the underground part of the plant as we know. And it is pale in color. It is present below the soil. The root system. The root is present as a complete root system, right? So there are two types of root system. That is stem root and fibrous root. Root is the underground part of the plant, pale in color. Roots have many branches. So these are classified into two types, tap root and fibrous root. So tap root is composed of a main root which grows from the base of the stem. So from the base of the stem, a main root grows, known as the tap root. And from this tap root, many branches and sub-branches arise, called lateral branches. So there will be a main root from the base of the stem. And to this main root, small lateral branches will be arising from the stem. So the stem continues to the ground in the form of a main root. From this main root, many branches and sub-branches arise. Those are known as the lateral roots. This type of root system we see in carrot, mango, pea and radish plant. So the next type of root system is fibrous root system. In this type, a cluster of thin root-like structures arise from the base of the stem. So in tap root, a main root arises, whereas in fibrous root, cluster is nothing but a bunch. A bunch of thin fiber-like root structures arise from the base of the stem. Tap root, a single root, main root arises. Fibrous root, many branches of roots, cluster of fibers arised. So these spread into the soil. These clusters, these branches of fibers spread into the soil. You see these in maize, grass, wheat and millet plants, this type of root system. If you want to see any type of root system, you have to remove the plant from the soil and observe. You have to wash the roots and then you can observe the type of root system in that. So if you take the plant from the soil and wash the roots, then you observe the type of root system in that plant. And suppose if you cut the roots and then plant the plant again in the soil, will the plant survive? No, right? Roots are necessary for the plant to survive. If you cut off the roots, the plant cannot survive. So what are the functions of the roots? It provides anchorage to the plant. Anchorage means it holds the plant. Then that is the reason it holds the plant firmly, because it provides anchorage to the plant. That means the main support to the plant, holds the plant firmly, absorbs the water and minerals from the soil. It takes the water and minerals from the soil and gives to the other parts of the plant. So that is the function of the root. So this was about root, and these are the experiments to prove the functions of the leaf.